Halloween is the season of horror, a day of the dead that celebrates the macabre, the wicked, and the haunting. However, Halloween can also be an excellent time for fantasy and science fiction. With elements of the supernatural, terrors beyond the stars, or just fantastic imagery, many horror films double or triple dip into both. Of the most prolific of monsters ever born from literature, the most famous of all is probably Dracula, the legendary vampire born from the novel of the same name. But there are still some who do not know the real man that inspired the legendary villain. His name was Vlad III Dracula, Prince of Wallachia, sometimes better known as Vlad the Impaler. Enter Dracula Untold, a dark fantasy film that attempts to blend the veils between history and cultural legend, telling the story of a Transylvanian prince that gives up everything to protect what he loves most from the invading Turks, only to turn into a monster in what is meant to launch a new franchise in a shared universe of horror icons under the Universal brand. And oh boy, does it fail miserably every step of the way. First and foremost, this is a movie that is doubly disappointing to me, and I'll lay my biases out right now. Bram Stoker's Dracula is perhaps my favorite novel of all time, challenged only by Romance of the Three Kingdoms. And Vlad III Dracula is a historical figure that has always fascinated me. I've been longing for two movies my whole life, one that truly captures the genuine terror of the literary Dracula, and one that chronicles the interesting, morbid tale of a real-life tragic villain and all the trappings that make him so infamously memorable. This is a movie that promises both, but delivers none of it. One of the main problems I have with it boils down to its portrayal of Dracula. It irks me in all the wrong ways. So the movie is intended as an origin story, so Dracula is portrayed as a heroic figure that eventually falls to darkness. However, it frames itself in the historical context of a real-life man who is very cruel, harsh, and twisted. So not only does it defy the suspension of disbelief, but his descent into darkness feels so sudden and contrasts so sharply with its source material, it only makes sense if you know the historical man behind the myth. As a fantasy movie, it is equally misguided in the worst way. Dracula is the hero of our story and the man we are supposed to root for. And while his powers are cool to watch, there's so little threat to him, the majority of the movie is pure spectacle because he is not at stake, pun intended. Instead, we're supposed to fear for the safety of those he protects, which he always seems to fail at miserably, in the most contrived ways. And all of this is being compounded on the fact that this legendary monster is supposed to be the hero in all of this. Everything's just clashing all at once, just so much of the movie clashes with itself. It also loses any semblance of a horror movie after the first act. Now that might be hit or miss depending on your taste, but for me, it was very much a miss. It is also riddled with holes in its own plot and logic. Now, fantasy doesn't have to be realistic, and that's one of the freedoms of the genre, but it is obligated to make sense according to the rules that it defines for itself. If it's constantly contradicting its own rules, it's so impossible to enjoy. If I could give the movie one compliment, it certainly is stylish. It has a lot of flashy visuals and cinematography, but there's very little cleverness in how it's used to tell us any more about the characters or the theme. It's all flash and no substance, similar to a film like 300. Dracula's powers are pretty cool to watch unfold on screen, but it always seems like when it's starting to finally pull its own weight with the effects and with all this cool stuff happening, there's something very distracting going on at the same time, subverting all the spectacle in the worst way. Now, Dracula Untold was enough of a success commercially that Universal went forward with plans for their shared monster universe. But the failure of 2017's The Mummy has put plans on hold for Universal's Dark Universe. Perhaps one day in the future, I'll get to see the day when my favorite villain from my favorite novel and my favorite villain from history finally earn the quality movies they deserve, but this is not it. If you're looking for a fantasy film to distract you from the terrifying ghosts, murdering psychopaths, and devilish demons that haunt your movie nights during October, well, you're best off looking elsewhere, I'm sorry.